What I want to talk about this morning is three levers that I think can be very effective. I want to talk about talent philosophy, kind of a new topic, the rules of the road for how you grow talent in your organizations. I want to talk about how we can improve our individual capabilities. What makes a great talent management leader, and how can we move closer to that ideal state? And talk a bit about one-page talent management. How can we ensure that our processes are simple, have great accountability, and great transparency? When we say talent philosophy, what do we mean? A talent philosophy, are your rules of the road for growing talent. It's the guiding principles that tell your organization how you're going to manage your various talent practices. The first area is just performance. How important is performance here? How much does that matter? Same question with behaviors. Behavior is a big deal, not a big deal. Differentiation, one of the more challenging questions that we face. How comfortable are we, or how much do we want to differentiate what we give those high potential leaders or high performing leaders versus average leaders? How much accountability do we want to have in the system? What sort of consequences do we want to have for people who are either great at building leaders or not so great at building leaders? And how transparent we want to be, both about the processes and about the outcomes from those processes. Given that the facts are pretty clear that maybe our current practices aren't working quite as effectively as they can, I'd like to suggest a different approach. What if we started with the core business problem that we're trying to solve? Not building an HR practice, not we need to build performance management, not we need to build talent reviews, but we need to ensure people are aligned with the needs of the business. We need to ensure we're predicting accurately who will succeed in the future. And then what if we did this? What if we started with the science? Because we know that core science works. We know that core science is amazingly robust and helpful. What if we asked ourselves, before we build a process, let's figure out what we know truly works in that process. And because we know that implementation is everything, why don't we find a way of ensuring that that process can actually be used? Why don't we turn the typical HR design model on its head, and instead of saying, how big can we make this, how complex, how elegant, why don't we challenge ourselves to say, how few steps could I put in this process and still have it work? How little information do I need to bring to that talent review table and still make smart decisions about people? And once we simplify, how do we add some more value in? How do we take that complex information in an engagement survey or a 360 or HR metrics data and boil it down in a way so we create that cake mix for managers? We find a way of making their lives as simple and easy as possible by doing the hard work behind the scenes. And let's talk about how you actually apply that. A couple of examples. Performance management, probably the most fundamental way to apply one-page talent management. Start with that business objective. What is the business objective? We're trying to align employees' efforts with the needs of the organization. And this is one of those areas where there is incredibly sound science. We have so much of a debt to pay back to the people who've done all this research for us. Some of the key things that we know from the research: harder goals produce higher results. Goals should align with self-interest. A well-written goal should help motivate us. Very clear. But that also means, and this is one of the two sentences from the book that's led to more controversy than anything else, employees setting their own goals does not increase motivation to perform those goals. So as long as goals align with self-interest, that's all that matters. And while it sounds very straightforward, a few goals is better than many goals. It's both true in the science and simply mathematically it follows that if I have four things to do and I add a fifth, I'm going to expend less effort across all five. If I add a sixth, less effort across all six. Thankfully, the science backs this up as well. I can't say it enough. All that matters is that it actually gets executed, because we know if it gets executed, it delivers the results.